Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel All Sorted. And in this second episode of the series of organization behavior, the HR knowledge, so we are going to talk about the most interesting unit in the organization behavior book, personally my favorite, which is related to human biases. How do we make decisions in daily life? How we can make decisions? How do actually people make decisions very wrongly, and all selective perception and halo effect? And this is going to be a very interesting PPT, trust me. You'll relate to everything that I say on this slide. It can help you in all the interviews. As I said, it can help you personally very well to understand yourself, understand how people make decisions and not fall prey to such decisions. Okay, so very interesting. It will help all the HRM aspirants, the students of MBA. Even if you are working in an organization, it will help you, big deal. And in general, if you want to understand about human psychology, how we make decisions, perceptions, biases, errors in judgments, chapter 3 of the Robbins book, which is called Perception and Individual Decision Making. Okay, so let's go ahead, guys. We'll start. So the agenda, what is the agenda? All right. So again, as I said in the last video, it will be very beneficial for HRM interviews of MBA in various colleges to understand organization behavior in general. For summer internships, if you are already a first year student of MBA, this will help you in the summer internships, questions related to HR. Okay, if this video again goes to 100 likes, the next video will be available soon with an interesting chapter. Will you be learning from this? The basic summary that you'll get after the end, I'll just tell you. You'll understand what is perception. Okay, how do we perceive things? Identify the shortcuts individuals use in making judgments. How do we actually make judgments very fast? Okay, and explain the link between perception and decision making. Okay, common decision biases, very interesting. Biases, kya hote hai? You must have heard, kya, he's so biased person. What is exactly bias and what are the types of biases? Okay, contrast the three, ethical decision criteria, what is ethical decision making, and define what is creativity and discuss the three component model of creativity. Starting, so what is perception? Okay, the classical definition in the book is how we perceive things. How we give meaning to what is reality to us. Okay, as we say, aap jis rang ka chashma hoge, the world will be like that for you. If you're wearing a red, a red specs, a red framed specs, you'll see the world red. So that is perception we have heard. What is the definition? So it's a process by which individuals organize and interpret their sensory impressions. Sensory impressions kya hota hai? आपके जो फाइव सेंसेस है उससे आप मीनिंग निकालते हो. ओके, इन ऑर्डर टू गिव मीनिंग टू द एनवायरनमेंट, क्या मीनिंग देते हो एनवायरनमेंट को. सो बेसिकली वेरी इजी डेफिनेशन, हाउ वी ऑर्गेनाइज एंड इंटरप्रेट द सेंसरी इंप्रेशंस इन ऑर्डर टू गिव मीनिंग टू आवर एनवायरनमेंट, दैट्स इट. व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स इन्फ्लुएंसिंग द परसेप्शन? देयर आर थ्री फैक्टर्स. ओके, फर्स्ट इज द व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन, द परसीवर ऑफ कोर्स, द पर्सन आई एम, एंड द टारगेट, व्हाट एम आई परसीविंग. सो थ्री थिंग्स गिव राइज टू परसेप्शन, वेरी वेरी इजी. ऑलराइट, so now we come to the attribution theory. Okay, this is very important. So what is called attribution? This is the perceivers, we try to attribute the observed behavior to a type of a cause. Koi cheez ho rahi hai to kisi ki wajah se ho rahi hai, there is some cause and effect, so somehow we attribute things to a specific cause. And those causes are two types, first is internal and second is external. Internal means the behavior is believed to be under the personal control of the individual. जो भी पर्सन कर रहा है, सपोज अ सेकंड पर्सन आई एम ऑब्जर्विंग, द फर्स्ट इंटरनल एट्रीब्यूशन मींस व्हाट एवर ही इज डूइंग, इट इज अंडर हिज पर्सनल कंट्रोल, व्हाट एवर एक्शंस ही इज डूइंग. सेकंड इज एक्सटर्नल, इट सेज दैट द पर्सन इज फोर्स्ड इनटू बिहेवियर बाय आउटसाइड इवेंट्स और कॉजेस. कि मुझे यार ये करना पड़ा, आई वॉज फोर्स्ड टू टेक दिस डिसीजन, आई हैड नो अदर ऑप्शन टू डू. वी हियर दिस सो मेनी टाइम्स. सो देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ एट्रीब्यूशन. First is internal. Okay, we believe that it is a person who is controlling his behavior. And second is external, which says that he is forced to take such certain decisions because of the outside events or causes. Simple. So there are some attribution errors, obviously. Okay. So now let's see what is fundamental attribution error. This is very important. First is the fundamental attribution error. It says that it is a tendency to underestimate the influence of external factors and overestimate the internal factors. As I said, there are two types of attribution we give, that is, first is internal, second is external. So what is fundamental attribution error? It is a tendency that we underestimate the influence of external factors and overestimate that of internal factors. like because of my hard work I succeeded, like because of my persistence, perseverance and whatnot, it's all because of me that I have cleared this exam. So tendency to underestimate the influence of external factors, that his teacher helped him, parents were supportive, not giving importance to that, but we say that mere wajah se ye kuch hua hai. So naturally rise hota hai self-serving bias because of this. So this occurs when individuals overestimate their own influence on success and overestimate the external influences on their failures. Ki because yaar kuch main suppose I have cleared UPSC exam. So we overestimate our internal things because I was so consistent, because maine itna padha 16-16 ghante 8-8 ghante 10-10 ghante itne marks leke, that's why I have gained success. So here I am overestimating my internal influence, okay, that is self-serving, that is serving me. So that's why it's called a bias, self-serving bias. I serve myself. Success hua hai to meri wajah se hua hai, mere hard work ke wajah se hua hai. And if I fail, then I overestimate the external influences. Yaar us saal ka paper hi tough aa gaya tha, right? Ye log kaise interview lete hai, they are, the interviewers are biased, they are not making right decisions. UPSC exam hi barabar design nahi hai. So if I fail, I give more importance to the external factors, but if I succeed, I give importance to the internal factors because of me. I'm sure you must relate, you will be relating to this. So now we all use shortcuts while judging others. Ab mano ya na mano, even if you believe or don't believe, there are shortcuts that we all use. We all have biases. There's no one person who can say I'm unbiased. Okay, so let's see what are the shortcuts that we used while judging others. So again, selective perception is the most important thing. Selective perception. Mera perception bahut selective hai. Selective kaise hai? A perceptual filtering process is based on interests, background and attitude. So based on my interest, my background, my attitude, I will perceive things very selectively. Now I'll give examples to these. Aap socho ki kya ho sakta hai example. Aap socho, thoda sa dimag dauda, aapko bhi maza aayega. I'll give examples of this. Let's go to the second shortcut. Second shortcut is the halo effect. Okay. हेलो इफेक्ट क्या होता है? ड्रॉइंग अ जनरल इंप्रेशन बेस्ड ऑन सिंगल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. वी ऑल हैव सीन दिस. वी गिव सो मच इंपॉर्टेंस टू वन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एंड देन जनरलाइज दैट दैट होल पर्सन इज लाइक दैट. सपोज कोई बहुत ब्यूटिफुल है, दैट इज कॉल्ड अट्रैक्टिवनेस बायस. इफ आई फाइंड समवन अट्रैक्टिव, आई विल फील दैट दे मस्ट बी नेचुरली गुड एट एवरीथिंग. इफ आई फील समवन इज वेरी गुड एट इंग्लिश, they are good at in the very fluent in English, we feel that the person is intellectual, he must be very good, very well read. Okay, this is called halo effect. You take one single characteristic and draw a general impression out of that. So that is called halo effect. Third one is the contrast effect. Now contrast effect by definition is our reaction is influenced by others we have recently encountered. Suppose there's a person just before me who goes to the interview and I feel that person is amazing. Okay, suppose MBA ka interview hai, test ka interview hai, that person is having 2-3 years of work experience into HR field, he is very attractive also, he is very well dressed, I feel that he'll be doing very awesome in the interview. And so the interviewer has recently encountered that person. Now whoever goes next in the interview will be seen in a different light. Suppose you are an interviewer, you just encountered a person who is very smart, he is from IIT, he did his MBA from IIM and now is sitting for an interview. Okay, I'll perceive him in a different light. Oh, what an amazing guy. Now whoever is coming next will face the consequence of my contrast effect, because I have just met a person who is very smart. That next person will be, you know, judged accordingly, because I have just encountered a person who is very smart. So my reaction is influenced by others who I have just recently encountered. Socho iske baare mein, you also think of examples. So fourth one is the stereotyping. Okay, the most heard term. What is stereotyping? We see that don't stereotype me. Okay, so it is basically judging someone on the basis of perception of the group to which they belong. So आपने सुना होगा कंजूस मारवाड़ी है, मारवाड़ी है इस पक्का कंजूस. वी जज समवन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ परसेप्शन ऑफ द ग्रुप टू विच दे बिलोंग. इफ दैट सपोज दैट ग्रुप इज वेरी स्मार्ट, विल स्टीरियोटाइप दैट पर्सन बिलोंगिंग टू दैट ग्रुप, ही मस्ट बी ऑल्सो स्मार्ट. लेट्स सी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सेलेक्टिव परसेप्शन. सो यू कैन सी द पिक्चर ऑफ कबीर सिंह. So Kabir is an avid runner and self-proclaimed health nut. Basically very health conscious person. Okay, he goes to the gym 2 times, eats very healthy. But Kabir is also a cigarette smoker. Okay, he's a chain smoker. So though he knows about the health risks of smoking, that smoking causes cancer, excessive smoking can be bad for lungs, but still he thinks that there will not be any adverse health risks as long as he exercises, eats well and smokes less. That only if I do one pack a day, ek main cigarette ka packet marunga to mereko kuch nahi hoga. If I am exercising, if I am having good diet, nothing can stop me. So while looking through a fitness magazine, ek magazine dekh raha hai, Kabir came across 2 advertisements. For a book about weightlifting and other was an advertisement about dangers of smoking tobacco. After reading the advertisement, Kabir went online and purchased the weightlifting book. However, he paid no attention to the smoking advertisement and forgot about it. Okay, before going to the next page. So basically his perception is very selective. He'll because he has already decided that smoking cannot harm me, so I'll completely ignore that information which is contrasting to my earlier belief. Okay, so I'll only pay attention to things that interest me, that are according to my own thinking, my own judgment. So this is called selective perception. Halo effect. We just talked about halo effect. That attractiveness stereotype. So there's one person who's attractive, one person not that attractive. So we'll always feel that the attractive people are perceived to be more smarter, funnier, and more likable than less attractive people. So this is a result of a research. Main example, basically one attractiveness stereotype is one example of halo effect. It can be anything. If someone is fluent in English, we'll feel that he is very intellectual. That's also called a halo effect. So a research conducted in 1968 by Rosenthal and Jacobson discovered that teachers generally develop expectations for their students based not merely on the school record but also on their physical appearance. This is a very harsh fact. So it was seen in researches that teachers give better grades to students who are more attractive. Okay, so higher grades were given, and also it was seen that in the online classes where the physical appearance was not visual to the teachers, they scored way less. The same students who were ranked, who were given better grades offline because of their physical attractiveness, they were rated higher, and in online classes, the grades dropped. So this was all right. I hope you'll remember the examples. That's why I gave you the examples of halo effect and the earlier one. What is the link between perception and decision making? My perception, my giving meaning to the environment, and my decision making. What is the link? So decision making occurs as a reaction to a perceived problem. Okay. So our perception influences what? Awareness that a problem exists, the interpretation and evaluation of information, and bias of analysis and conclusions. So first of all, what is the rational decision making model? Aapne suna hoga ki don't be biased, be rational. Don't be emotional, be rational. So what is rationality and how do we make decisions? So first of all, that is called rational decision making model. And first we define the problem. Next we identify the decision criteria. So what is my criteria for a decision? Then allocate weights to the criteria. Suppose there's an interview. I need to find a guy for the interview for a certain position. I'll first identify what is the decision criteria. These things are very important in the candidate that I'm looking for. Then I'll allocate weights. So for communication, I'll give 20%. For technical skills, I'll give 30%. For behavioral skills, I'll give again 30%. Likewise, decide weights. Then develop the alternatives. Evaluate the alternatives. Okay. And select the best alternative. So this is called rational decision making model. So this is seldom used actually. It is more of a goal than practical method. So we would aspire to become rational, but most people are not making decisions rationally. So what is the assumptions of the model, rational decision making model? That we have complete knowledge of the situation, that I know everything about the situation. I can weigh the pros and cons. All relevant options are known in an unbiased manner. The decision maker seeks the highest utility. So, but the, now this is called bounded rationality. What is bounded rationality? We saw what is rational decision making model, but our rationality is not very rational 100%. We are bounded by our limited information. We do not have complete information, as I said earlier. So that is called bounded rationality. We make decisions based on our very limited knowledge. So limited information processing capability of human beings makes it impossible to assimilate and understand all the information necessary to optimize. Because inherently we have limited processing capability of humans, of the limited information that we have. So we cannot make decisions rationally. That is called bounded rationality. So people seek solutions that are satisfactory and sufficient, just satisfactory and sufficient rather than optimal. Okay, bounded rationality is constructing simplified models that extract the essential features from problems without capturing all their complexity. We cannot capture all the complexity because we are bounded. We have bounded rationality due to the limited information processing capacity that we have. So if someone says that he's a very rational, completely rational person, tell him that no, we humans don't have that capability and we all have bounded rationality. So decision making in bounded rationality. We saw decision making in rational model. Now in bounded rationality, how do we make that? So it is simpler than rational decision making, obviously, because rational decision making is quite complex and to process that whole information is not very capable for human beings. Very few humans are able to do that. So there are three steps in this. So basically we search limited search for criteria and alternatives, familiar criteria and easily found alternatives. Okay, limited review of alternatives and satisfying, just selecting the first alternative which is good enough. So this is this can be very well applicable in interviews. Okay, that I'll limitedly go to the tier one colleges. Okay, I'll not review the tier two colleges, tier three colleges, and satisfying selecting the first alternative. Pehle college mein gaya and he's a good enough guy. Let's hire him. So this is one example of decision making, which is bounded rationality. Right. Now, what is intuitive decision making? In the last video, we already saw what is intuition and it is not backed by data or research, and what is systematic decision making. So here, intuitive decision making, it's a non-conscious process created out of distilled experience, but it increases, the intuitive decision making increases the more experience we have, and it can be a powerful complement to rational analysis and decision making. All right. So we don't have a scientifically backed data of how intuitions work, but it grows with experience and it's a non-conscious process. This is the most important part, the most interesting. So pay attention to this, guys. The common biases and errors. We say he's a biased person, I am biased, that interviewer was biased. What is bias? What are the types of biases? Bias aapko I hope samajh aata hai. Okay. A biased person is not a person who is rational. He has limited decision making capacity and that's why he uses shortcuts to judge people. So guys, I hope you like this video, and if you want the video on biases, what are the types of biases, and you want me to release that video on this channel, so please give like to this video, reach it to 100 likes, and the video on biases, the kind of biases we have, it will be a very interesting video. If you want that, please subscribe and please like this channel, and the next video will be uploaded soon on the types of biases that we humans have. In the next video, reach it to 100 likes, and the next video will be uploaded very, very soon. I promise that.